we're now going to talk about one of a bit of a revered species. It's the blue skate, otherwise known as the marbled skate or marbled ray, not to be confused with the marble electric ray. So stick to blue skate. Deciartus pastinaca. Why are they so revered? They are probably the species responsible for the most spikings, if you want to call it a spiking, along our coast at least. They are, in my terms, a very vicious flatfish. They quite a stout fish. Okay, so compared to a brown skate is quite an elongated, more flattened species. These are sort of that little chubby fat kid that no one likes. They very bulky, and they've got a short, very fat tail. So instead of a nice, long, thin, more supermodel-esque kind of tail, it's a nice, chubby-ish fish with a nice fat tail, and normally at least two spikes sitting on the tail, and they'll sit up like that. When you do catch them, they very often can rear their back up like that, and they've been known to pull their tail all the way over and get you in the front, almost like a scorpion. But normally, as soon as you pull him out, he just starts whipping his tail backwards and forwards like that. And yeah, for some reason, they're extremely grumpy. Don't know why. Maybe they've seen themselves in the mirror. But yeah, you have to be very careful when you are handling these. And just as long as you abide to the general rules of handling the fish, keep your fingers out of the spiracles. And what I've found works very well is to get either soft cloth or something like a softer shoe so you don't damage the fish, and just to wrap that around where the spike is itself, because then he really can't do anything to you. Otherwise, if you are on the sand, you can put your foot with a shoe onto the tail itself. Don't push down and break the tail. Just want to keep it there just so you can't pull it out and get whoever's helping you to get the hook out. Overall appearance, like we said, quite a chunky fish. Extremely beautiful blue markings on it. But yeah, that vicious attitude sort of detracts from that attractiveness. In terms of your targeting wise, it's really more of a winter species, not really a summer species, especially up here by us. You often catch them when you're targeting cob. So a nice working bank, very nice area, very similar to cob water. And you're looking at sardine is probably the best bait, especially down further south, but up here it works very well. A nice soft sardine bait, and choco works extremely well for them as well. In terms of their maturity, you're looking at a disc width. So remember, guys, you're not measuring from the nose all the way to the tip of the tail. You measure across the fish. You're looking at a disc width of about 50 centimeters, so half a meter. They bear live young, so the babies are born alive. And often the guys have seen this when they're landing those big females, that they actually give birth to all their pups. And the pups are about 15 to 20 centimeters normally disc width, so really nice, small, beautiful little marked fish. Size wise, after that you're looking at a big fish is anything over 20 kilos. Normally you're looking around the 8 to 15 kilos is your average sort of range. When they do get those, you do get the big pregnant females, we've caught them up to about 27, 28 kilos. That's an extremely big blue skate. So anything above 20 is a really notable catch. Tackle-wise, medium tackle is more than strong enough for them. You're normally using slightly smaller baits, so a nice mushy sardine and choco mix is one of the best. Otherwise, they will eat a whole red eye. It works very well off Scottburgh Point. Plain choco bait by itself, a nice snotty choco bait that you would use for cob, works very well. If you are targeting cob and you are getting blue skates, and you're getting annoyed at that, put a little bit more foam in your bait just to get it up off the bottom. That often helps just to get it away from the blues, because they do feed on the bottom. It's a very popular fish, like a lot of our flatfish, very popular amongst the competitive anglers. They do not make good eating, so release them safely. But very popular. We do get blue skate smashes when they congregate, and you can catch just 5 fish very, very quickly. So yeah, very popular fish. A nice one to put on the list, but yeah, do be careful of those spikes and get out there in winter. Maybe see if you can't target an edible amongst all the other edible fish you're catching. And get out there, catch a blue. Cheers.